subject, verb and remained. Few rules yesterday we have seen with examples in detail. Now today we will see the next rules with few example, and after that we'll take one exercise on that. Means here we will complete our lesson. So we'll start the next rule, that is rule number 7, that is use of each, every. Subject, our topic is subject, verb, agreement. Subject in number, numbers that must agree with verb. So here we are learning today rule number 7, that is use of each and every, even though connected by the one word, that is and. And I repeat, each and every, use of each and every, even though that is connected with the word and, and it takes singular verb. It takes singular verb. That is, we'll go to example. One example is this: every boy and every girl was given vaccination. Starts the use of each and every. Every boy and every girl. Every boy and every girl. See, it is attached with and. And as we said that it takes a singular verb. Each. Ek ladka, ek ek ladke, ladki ko. So that is our verb is here. Was. That is a singular verb. It takes a singular verb. We'll go to second example. Every man and every woman is. Every man. See, each boy or each man or each, that we can say either this is every or it is, whether it is each, and when it is connected, even though it is connected or not connected, then also it takes a singular. See here, every man and every, it starts with see every, here also every, and attaching with and takes a singular noun, that is we have taken here is. Very easy to understand this each and every. We'll go to next is rule number 8. That rule number 8 is nouns like glasses. Glasses, see, these are my glasses, spectacles, chashma. Now, nouns like glasses, pants, trousers, shoes, people, police, scissors, it always, like this noun, always take a plural verb. In this case, you know, like, you know, the especially the ends with S. See, it's a pair. Nouns like glasses, spectacles, pants, here the trousers, you know, the shoes, here this is, you know, we can say the collective noun. This police, according to the sentence, we can take police, if the sentence is accordingly, the singular police also there, and the police, the group of many policemen, they are together, we say police only. Okay, so shoes, here S is there, here the scissors are there. They always take their agreement. These nouns, when comes, they take the plural verb. It agrees with the plural verb. Okay, we'll go to examples, very easy examples. My spectacles. My spectacles are on the table. My spectacles are on the table. Understand? And what is that then? Again, my shoes are very glossy. My shoes are red in color. Shoes. S. Your spectacles. So here, these nouns like glasses, spectacles, plants, trousers, and all the scissors always take a plural verb. They takes always a plural verb. So here I have given here the shoes. Okay. Here the shoes are there. But one thing is there. See, the you have to know that, but when used with a pair of means when it is attached, a pair of, see this is a pair of jodi, pair of jodi, understand? But when it used with a pair of, they are singular, they are singular, so they take a singular verb. It agrees with the singular verb. Here the shoes, shoes, that's, it's a plural, so takes agrees with the plural verb. But when we are saying a pair of, when it is there a pair of, so agree with the singular verb, that is a pair of branded shoes. But we have attached the a pair of shoes. It takes the singular verb. A pair of branded shoes is very expensive. Is takes singular. Singular is very expensive these days. Here we have taken my shoes are glossy. Shoes take plural verb. We have written plural verb, but attaching with the a pair of, you always write a singular verb. It agrees with the singular verb. So a pair of a branded shoe is very expensive. Now we'll go to rule number 9. Now we'll see rule number, the next rule is that uncountable nouns. Uncountable, that we cannot count in numbers like this. Okay, so the rule number 8 is uncountable nouns like advice, news, media, stationery, weather, weather, the climate, you know, weather, progress, are in singular. These nouns are in singular, you know, stationery. When we go stationery, you know, in the shop, stationery shop, that is, weather, progress are in singular, takes singular verb. I repeat, the uncountable nouns like stationery, media, weather, advice, news, progress are always in a singular, they are in singular, so they take agree with a singular verb. Now we'll go to example. Her advice has not been considered. Advice, uski salaha, right? That is not taken. He has not advised. Uncountable noun agrees with singular, so here has is a singular verb and here is the uncountable noun, that is advice. That news is not good. News, news, that's again I say uncountable, so here is a news and here the one singular verb that we have taken is. Today's weather is bright. Today's weather, today's climate is bright, so singular, so here the weather is there and here singular verb agrees with. Now if you can say that my progress is very good, we can say, understand? And like this way, uncountable advice and these are always takes the singular noun. Okay, now we'll go to rule number 10, that is nouns like senior. News here also we have taken, or here also, okay? But see here, nouns like news, physics, P-H-Y-S-I-C-S, physics, 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 Mrs. Mrs. one type of, you know, this is that it comes here. Mrs. or vaccine, we can say, you know, like news, physics, measles, cards, aerobics are in plural form. Are in plural form, and but they are treated as a singular. But they are treated as a singular. See, once again, nouns like news, physics, measles, cards, economics, we can say Arabics are in plural form. When we see act together, we think that that's the plural. But it is, they are treated as a singular. Now, if you see news, we have taken see news. Here, physics ending with S. Measles, that is yes. But it is in plural form, but treated as a singular. So, agrees with the singular verb. Agrees with the singular verb. We'll come to the example. It will be very clear for you now, dear children. Physics. Ending with S. If we see, we think that it's a plural, but treated as a singular. So, it's taken that here, physics, S is there. We have taken the singular noun, singular verb. Now, physics is very hard subject. Come to here, Arabics is, can you see here, S. But still, it is singular, so we have taken a singular noun. Is a good exercise. Very easy, dear children. If you practice it, if you go through that, you know, so it is very easy. Only few things, you know, each, every, and like this way, the S and all, there, each, nothing, either, there, neither. There you get difficult. But in that case also, if you that sentence, if you translate in your mother tongue, it is very easy. Kya likhna hai? Wo ja rahi thi, wo ja rahe the. Wo aa raha tha, wo aa rahe the. You know, in our mother tongue, if you are translating, it's very easy. Which verb attached there, which verb is will agree with, whether it is singular or plural. Come to the rule number 11. Quantities of time, money and distance. Quantity of time, money, distance always takes agree with the singular verb. I repeat, distance, money, time, that takes always singular. See the example. 200 rupees. It is not 1 rupee. It is 200 rupees. More than 1 rupee. But we are taking singular. See here. 200 rupees is. Are you getting 200 here? The money, quantity of money, it's 1. Even though the quantity is 200, 1000, 1 lakh, 5 lakh, doesn't matter. It's a 1 quantity. Right? So that is a quantities. So 200 rupees is too much for this bag. Come to second point, second example. 2/3 of the city is in ruins. 2/3 of the city, kya ho gayi? Kharab ho gayi, ruins. So that is the, you know, distance we can say, or we can say the time we can say city is. So here the 2/3, you know, and 10 kilometer is much to go by walk. Distance is, we have written here, is. So now here the 11 rules are there. Now we'll take one exercise, and we have seen all the rules, and now the exception, you know, remember dear children, here, you know, remember that the few nouns are always plural. Few nouns are always plural even though they don't end in S. I think so it's very common for the 9th standard, for the 10th standard, as we have come, you know, from the beginning. So it is not there, and we are learning beginning from, you know, from the pre-primary in the English medium school. So we know, but still, as it is a rule that I have to explain that few nouns are always plural even though they don't end with the letter S. They always take a plural. Even though, you know, teeth, hair we can see, you know, my hair, one hair, hairs, thousand hair, lakh hair. There we can say the singular. Under singular, hair is long. Hairs are long, we cannot say. That only the exception. Here, the S, they always take a plural. means that like children, oxen, police, all the people, like this way. Now see the example. People have, so here in people have, it is a plural, so we have taken the plural verb. The police were baffled. Dear children, see here, the police, we can say the many police are there. If I am saying that the police is on the road, you can see police is on the road. Maybe the many police, or maybe if you are writing is also there, that is also correct. So here, but as we have taken the group, even though you know few nouns are always a plural, but sometimes one police also, eight police, many police only. So here were baffled. The children are in bed. The children is a plural, we are here. My teeth, you know, teeth is name, teeth are. Okay, in this way, some nouns are there, not ending with S, but we are always agrees with the plural verb. I think so, dear children, all the things which we have taken, all the rules, I think so, it's very easy, and if you practice it more and more, and if you solve the exercise, it will be very, very easier for you. So very small exercise will take only the 6 exercise. You just tell me, then here we will conclude our this lesson. There people in the, again I am telling you, if you feel anything hard over here, you translate that sentence in your own language, that you will get the very easy, you will get answer. Which verb I have to attach, agree with that sentence. So, there police in the hall. The people in the hall. In the hall, of course, many people are there. So, what will come here? There are people in the hall. There is people, we cannot say. So, when the sentence starts with there, we can write according to that sentence. What is the meaning of that sentence? According to that verb, will agree. Now, there are cat? No. It will not work. There is a cat under the table. According to the sentence, you just add the verb. Now, the man with roses, here the answer is there. Look like your brother. What will come here? What is the sentence? Sentence tells about the what is the subject? Tells something about that subject. Is the subject of that sentence. Telling about the roses or telling about the man? Yes. Telling about the man. The man with the roses. Jo haath mein phool pakda hua hai. He is like your brother. So the man is in singular or plural? Yes, you are correct. It's in singular. So this will also come singular. So what will come answer? L-O-O-K-S looks. Right? The man with the roses looks. We are here. The subject is here. Telling about, the sentence is telling about this man. Okay. So we go to the next. This is easy. As just now earlier we have seen mathematics, economics, aerobics, new and that. Mathematics is my favorite, even though it's ended with S, but we have to take a singular verb. Is my favorite subject. Fifth one. Each of the girls. What is that? Even though here the either. Each AKA. Looks good on the ek ladki stage pe achhi lag rahi thi, sundar lag rahi thi. Ek ladki, har ek. So look, not looks, but here it's a will come looks, not
clue.
Either the cups or the glasses. We have yesterday we have learned that when the verb starts, you know, the when this starts with a subject joined with nor, near, or neither, either, neither, the verb agrees with the nearest subject. When this starts with either, neither, and what is that? That nearest subject or the third form of the subject. What is this? Either the cups or the glasses. Or the glasses. Already I had written. Or the glasses. Either the cups or the glasses. What is that? When it starts with either, that is with the third form, which is the glasses. So this is an S plural. So of course here is plural. I think so. With very clear, you understood. I hope you understood this lesson. I have given you the worksheet. Go through all the worksheets. Try to write with your own, with pencils, and check your answers. Thank you and have a nice day.